Parkridge High School. I'm Maggie Salerno.
And I'm Ashley Flores, and welcome to Pro TV.
On this episode, you'll hear about the school's sports, clubs, and activities.
First, let's look at what's going on with DECA, lacrosse, and PEAK.
DECA, the business competition that Park Ridge students have been excelling at for the last 2 years. On February 22nd to February 24th, Park Ridge students went down to Cherry Hill, New Jersey, and tested their skills against other schools. Let's go and find out how they did.
DECA is a marketing club. Basically, it consists of a role play and a test, and students take the knowledge that they've learned in class and apply it to a real-life situation. DECA stands for Distributive Educative Clubs of America. DECA is a really good way to work on your presentation skills, to think on the fly, to practice what you've learned in marketing or the business classes, and it's a good glimpse of what a career in the business field would be like. I think it's something that's very beneficial to the students. If you want to do DECA, sign up for a marketing class or a business class, and we'll get you started.
Mr. DeLisi, what do you have to say about this?
You advance through the rounds depending on how well you do in the computerized test and then the role plays that you would participate in. One excels in DECA by taking as many business courses as they can, by practicing the role plays in advance. There's very good real-life situations or scenarios that they would ask you about, and depending on how well you do, you would advance into the subsequent round.
Scott Desmond, would you have any thoughts on the subject?
My experience with DECA this year started at the regional level at Ramapo College. There, I moved on to the state rounds, where we did two more role plays, and then I qualified for state finals, and then in my competition event that ended there. But in another event I did, I qualified for the International Career Development Conference in Orlando in this spring. I would definitely recommend DECA for other people. It's a great opportunity to practice interviews and job skills, like talking face to face and thinking on your feet and quickly responding to questions about anything.
Danielle, what were your favorite things about DECA?
When you go to the DECA competition, they have these like speakers come in, and one was a magician and one was a hypnotist, and you kind of get to watch them perform and whatnot. To prepare for DECA, I would take a bunch of practice tests and do a couple practice role plays and look at the performance indicators.
Preston DeMarco, the man, the myth, the legend. Let's see what he has to say.
English, English, give me the news. I've got a bad case of DECA states. No role play gonna cure my ill.
Spring sports starting. We interviewed the lacrosse players and Coach Harvey about the upcoming season.
We just played a winter season, and it was great for us. It helped us, get sticks in our hand. We had about 26 guys sign up and play in a smaller field. And the great thing about the small field is it makes you really, really see the spacing and how important movement is on offense and how to work together on defense. So it really prepared us for the season. Really excited about the season. This is our second year now, so we've had a ton of growth. It's great to drive around Park Ridge and Emerson and see so many kids with lacrosse sticks in their hands playing. We have a lot of goals for this season. We're still a JV team this year, but we're playing 15 games. Really our goal is just to keep on getting athletes excited about lacrosse, teach them the game, and get ready for our first varsity season next year. Have a good time, we'll learn, come together as a team, bond, and keep on building lacrosse.
I think the this year's lacrosse season is going to be a great time because we have a lot of new kids joining from the upper grades, and then we have a lot of kids who are eighth graders who are freshmen now who are going to be joining the team. I like playing with Emerson. They make up a half of our team, and they make the team stronger overall, and they're it's good to have them. As a team, I think this year we plan to we're going to play a lot better. We have more experience now. We were just starting out last year, and we still had a pretty decent year.
Hi, I'm Joseph DiNicolo, and I'm here with some information about PEAK. Here's Mrs. Bernardo and Miss Batista.
Parkridge PEAK has been around for the last 8 or 9 years. It was started by a Parkridge parent, Mrs. Stacy Laxer. PEAK stands for Parents, Educators, Administrators, and Kids. It's an organization whose goal is to support the educational, emotional, and social welfare of all children and to create an inclusive environment for children with special needs and their families.
To become a mentor, you have to, in the beginning of the year, there's a sensitivity training that we do. It's about 2 hours, 2 to 3 hours. Middle and high school students participate in this and they find it very rewarding. After they're done training, a lot of them gain a lot of experience. They also can take this experience and they sometimes put it in their resumes, which is a great thing because they can use it for future if they want to go into any kind of child care.
We do in PEAK include a 10-week bowling program, which then the PEAK bowlers can go on and participate in Special Olympics bowling. We do a 5-week PEAK basketball program. We encourage you to come to as many activities as possible. You do not have to come to all. That's the beauty of this club. You come when you can. If you have any questions, seek one of us out. Seek out another mentor. Don't be shy. Get involved. Thank you.
Stigma is a recurring problem throughout high schools everywhere, and Mr. Yeager and his team have decided to take a stand and promote a stigma-free environment in Parkridge High School.
Stigma is basically a belief, usually a false belief, and usually a negative false belief in an idea, which usually conjures up sort of a negative image. So a stigma about mental health in particular would be kind of the belief and the feelings of that are negative about mental illness, and it's usually wrong.
Yeah, I don't view people with mental illnesses as people who have problems.
A stigma-free environment will help people get better grades and to become happier while they're in school.
Any significant amount of stress completely undermines our ability to learn because the brain requires a certain amount of energy to focus, to remember, to consolidate new information. Depression in particular, but any kind of stress, makes it very difficult for the brain to do any of those things. And these are all the things that are critical for learning.
The more people are like aware of what people are dealing with, because nobody really knows what everyone's dealing with, everyone has their own battles, and when you're mixed in with school and everything else you have going on, a lot of people can be very judgmental and kind of take out what they're going through on other people. And if stigma-free, everyone would kind of be less judgmental with everything.
Everyone should be different from one another, and I don't really think that they should be viewed as any worse than anyone else. Just a fact about their life that's pretty cool.
There's a lot of good support, so it's just getting kids to recognize that this is a problem, or I recognize this, maybe not in myself, but somebody else, and we just say, hey,
we were very happy to announce that Mrs. Huffman was this year's Parkridge High School Educator of the Year. She's always done an outstanding job supporting the PRHS student body and has shown a superior ability to inspire students of all backgrounds and abilities to learn. Once the selection committee makes a choice from those nominated, a public announcement is made to the staff and community, and the Educator of the Year is awarded a special trophy for their hard work and efforts to inspire all students.
In mid to late January, Mr. Letterman came in with flowers to share the information that I had been voted for Educator of the Year. I was taken by surprise. I was in a little bit of shock, but very grateful in the same respect. This year has been an extremely difficult year. I lost a colleague and a friend, someone I consider family. We worked side by side for 8 years. He was always the first person in this office every morning. And he used to have a very funny saying. He would say, if I'm not here, start without me. And so, unfortunately, the day that we learned of his passing, we had to start without him, and we unfortunately have had to do that ever since.
In the unfortunate passing of Mr. Mioli and Mrs. Heller being out of maternity leave, Mrs. Huffman was really the staple that held the department together and kept the school up and running on behalf of the guidance department. And, you know, it's not only this year that she's gone above and beyond her call of duty. She's willing to help out whenever someone needs help. And she was a tremendous candidate for Park Ridge High School this year.
So, Ms. Hoffman's a great guidance counselor. I just came new to this school this year, but she's been great. She's helped me out a lot and helped me select my courses and everything that I've done.
Again, this year's been extraordinarily tough for all of us. Especially this department, but we know that he's with us, and as his wife says, he's looking down on us and smiling. So with that, I'm so happy to accept this award on behalf of our department and him.
Hey guys, I'm Michael Russell. I'm in 11th grade, aka Junior. And we're in National Nutrition Month. In our cafeteria, our staff is helping our students make healthy lunch choices as possible in Park Ridge High School. What do you think we need to make healthier at the school?
I think we need more fruits and vegetables with our meals.
I think the school lunches are good. The students can buy them. And it's quick and easy. I think there's definitely some healthy stuff that's offered, especially on the left line with the hot foods for kids to eat.
I think the lunch staff is doing a tremendous job, especially Miss Bridget with those cookies. Oh, they're delicious in every single way, and just everything is amazing.
What's your favorite food at lunch?
I really like the cookies and the ice cream. It's my favorite part.
This is Michael Russell, aka Russanity, logging off. Have a good day.
Thank you, Mr. Yeager and Michael Russell, for some great tips. And congratulations, Mrs. Huffman, on your award.
Many students this year have been working very hard and making creative videos.
First, let's look at Amy Bravo and Ali Jago's project about a nostalgic trip through the 90s.
Hurry up! Ever power, ever proud, to say it ever loud.
Turn it up!
Mom, come down here right now, okay?
Emphasis!
You nasty.
Let's play some football.
Goldberg. The box said it would be a honeymoon to Auburn.
Honey, you missed Auburn big time.
Check with the seniors and juniors and see what they can remember about the 90s and early 2000s.
What was your favorite Hannah Montana song?
Party in the USA.
What kind of toys did you have when you were a kid?
Barbie and Ken.
From Zoe 101, did you believe that PCA was a real school?
Yeah.
Did you want to go?
Yeah.
What was your favorite Disney sitcom?
Sweet Life of Zack and Cody.
Drake or Josh?
Josh.
Are you a 90s kid?
No.
Backstreet Boys or NSYNC?
Backstreet Boys.
What was your favorite word art?
I have to say it was either between that one or that one.
I'm gonna have to go with the rainbow word art.
Did you have a crush on Danny Phantom?
Yes.
Yeah.
Of course.
A few moments later.
If Danny Phantom's Mike Lacordaire, then yes.
Yes.
And now, for a moment with Amy.
We're more than just friends. Oh, baby, it's right.
It's Brittany. You can go hit me, baby, one more time.
We're saying everything to me times two.
Oh, I knew this!
If somebody what? Can tell me who.
I know this.
Come on.
My fire.
Joey knows.
Backstreet Boys, right? Tell me why. Am I right?
All right, since Olivia got it wrong, we're going to give her another try. We're going to give her Paco to help out.
If you want to be my lover,
it's not the name.
Thus concludes A Moment with Amy.
What was your favorite Nicktoon?
Rugrats.
SpongeBob.
Eliza Thornberry.
So, what was your favorite playground game?
Hide and go seek. I was never found.
Well, that was radical. We hope you enjoyed that little blast from the past.
And if you're feeling slumpy, don't be grumpy.
Just remember the things that used to make you smile when you were a kid.
Hey guys, Alec and
Patrick here.
We're going to bring you a quick segment on a 12th grade English project that we recently finished up. The project involved picking a poem by a famous poet, and you had to make a video about it, interpreting the poem yourself.
Yep.
And we were put in small groups, and here are some examples of the videos.
Enjoy.
Out of the night that covers me, black is the pit from pole to pole. I thank whatever gods may be for my unconquerable soul. In the fell clutch of circumstance, I have not winced nor cried aloud. Under the bludgeonings of chance, my head is bloody, but I'm bowed. Beyond this place of wrath and tears looms but the horror of the shade, and yet the menace of the tears finds and shall find me unafraid. Matters not how straight the gate, how charged with punishments the scroll. I am the master of my fate. I am the captain of my soul.
Good day.
If you are late to school, bring a donut.
So it's really important that you use the class time wisely, get your projects done, because Megan, you're 20 minutes late.
I'm sorry, but I brought a donut.
Okay.
To easily peel a clementine, roll it in the palm of your hands.
To amplify your music, put it in a toilet paper roll.
To tie your shoe faster, use this simple way.
If you talk into the mic, you are able to say longer things in a snap chat. Just like that.
Thanks for watching.
We hope these life hacks work for you.
As well as they work for us.
On the show tonight, we have a behind the scenes with Al Witness News.
Hi, guys.
I'm Alec. This is Mike.
I'm Mike.
This is Patrick.
We'd just like to thank Danny for having us on the show tonight. It's a pleasure.
Thank you.
We got some great stuff coming out on TV, and yeah.
Really be a part of the network.
Really excited.
You mind if we ask some questions for the viewers?
Go ahead.
Yeah, sure.
How long does it take to edit?
It takes me 0 minutes. Exactly. I have a great workflow.
Mike. Well, thank you. Depending on the week, it could take anywhere from, including filming and editing, about 22 hours in terms of in school, out of school, and then on Thursday, throughout the entire day from about 4 p.m. until 2 a.m., just getting everything right, balancing sound, making sure we have the right effects, and doing all special effects. And my friend helps me a little bit over here, right?
Yeah, to start off, I used to edit the weather and the other segments, and then I'd send them over to Pat, and then Pat would compile the entire video along with the news. It was a great workflow. It's great teamwork.
Wow, that's a long time. How long does it take to film everything for the show?
My part usually takes about 4 hours, actually.
A minute with Mike.
Yeah, it takes forever.
A minute with Mike is about 4 hours with Mike, to be honest, yeah.
How do you guys prepare for everything?
You know, like Heath Ledger, I remember before the Batman movie, he went to a hotel for a month and he lived there alone in order to like get ready for the part. So usually like 10 minutes before I'll put some gel in my hair, like put some Old Spice on, get Suave, a comb, a little comb through it just to spice up my my appeal.
I just put on a tie. The shirt.
They usually just jump right into it, like a diver in a pool.
What is the most challenging part for getting everything set for Al Witness News on Fridays?
Honestly, I think getting the lines right and also probably the lighting. We have issues with those too, a lot.
Lighting takes about 10 years, the lines take another 20. And then somehow we just jump into a time machine and, you know, go back to, you know, that week and edit. It's a long time.
I mean, with the video and everything, I appreciate everything being perfect, but sometimes with Pat being a perfectionist, it just gets stressful.
And then what do you think it means to the people and, like, members of Park Ridge High School that you guys do this every Friday?
Well, we started this program, Danny, to really, you know, involve the school more, and get them get them hyped, I guess you'd say. It's basically how television affected America. We've affected the school, and we've just brought things, you know, closer to the kids, and they can see it every Friday morning. It's a great program.
Yeah, we do this for the school, like, not for ourselves.
Yeah.
I just want to thank you guys for coming on my show.
No problem.
Hope you guys had a great time.
Yeah. Any last words, Danny?
No, I think we're good.
All right.
Today, we are going to talk about owls. Not just any type of owl, but the Parkridge owl. Owls like to read books about owls. Owls watch other owls read books about owls. Did you know a group of owls is called a parliament? I bet you didn't, but now you do. The owl is a very social creature, and many of us are very curious of the things they do with their secret ritual dancing, or their secret ritual speaking, or the things that secretly happen in those secret corridors that many owls will naturally hide themselves in at night. Owls are very active creatures, and many of us all wonder, where will the owl go? The owl is far-sighted, so it cannot see too up close, but it's very well at inspecting faraway surfaces and prey. Sometimes an owl is awoken, and they must feast for their prey. Owls are also very artistic creatures, and they see things that many humans cannot see. They see different colors and shades and different auras of everything. But most importantly, the owl is a keen and intellectual creature. Today we learned about the owl. But truthfully, there is one important thing that we all should know. That there is an owl in all of us. And you, the viewer.
Great job, guys.
Thanks for watching, and see you next time on Pro TV.
Hoot.
Hoot.
Too much?